lovely Pisces, welcome to your weekly general reading for February 25th, 2024. I will begin your reading with crystal scrying and continuing on with the tarot and some oracle at the end. Let's go ahead and roll and see what spirit has in store for you, my lovely friends. Holy Spirit, Holy Divine, all who are with me in the highest divine realms of love and truth, I ask that you please show me, tell me, or both, what does the zodiac sign of Pisces need to know for the upcoming week's energies, please, Spirit? Thank you. Here. Okay, thank you. Okay, and who is Pisces? Okay, well, aren't you going to make me blush? Okay, so Pisces, I am seeing some kind of relationship here. Now, it looks romantic, but it doesn't have to be, okay? But what I'm seeing is, I'm seeing a masculine and feminine, not gender specific, kissing. Now, that can mean, of course, intimate, but it can also mean like family, you know, someone who is very close to another person. Growing a bigger bond, okay, or two people coming together. So it could be like a long lost family member that's coming back into the picture, something like that as well. It could also be you know, some kind of union as far as, you know, like a business partner as well too. Okay, and then to the side, I am seeing a huge shaggy dog. So that's telling me that, you know, because this dog is like staring right at you and the person that you're kissing. So by it staring at you like that, you know, a dog is a representative of unconditional love, protection, loyalty, best friend, that type of energy. So I really feel like that's the kind of energy that's going to be overall within this relationship, whatever this is. But then here's the thing. Off in the distance, there is this person that has this huge head. Now, a head for me represents either an authoritative type person who would be like teacher, leader, supervisor, could be parent, grandparent, aunt, uncle, something like, you know, in the lines of that. Now, this person has another person. It's almost like it's a feeling that they're like they're dating someone or they're with someone else. Okay, I'll just put it that way. But they're behind the person with the big head. Okay, so it's like they're not even paying attention to the person they're with. Their eyes are on you, Pisces, in this relationship. Okay, so for an example, if let's say you worked at a certain job and you left that job, you realized, okay, hey, this is toxic. I don't like this workspace or whatever. And you walk away and you find another job because it's, you know, it really can represent, you know, another workplace, person, place, situation. And you're happy there because I'm seeing you kissing this person, right? So you're happy there. And your old boss is, you know, not even focusing on what they have right there presently. They're focusing on what they lost. Okay. I hope that makes sense. All right. So anything else with this spirit? No. Okay. What else would you like to tell Pisces, please? Here. Okay. And who is Pisces? Okay. And who is this? Oh, wow. Okay. So there may be some kind of communication coming in because it's like spirit showing me, it's almost the same vision of the two people kissing, but this time, each person is like, you guys are looking eye to eye and like soul to soul, heart to heart. having some kind of discussion. So you may receive some kind of message, or you may be placing that message yourself, you know, something verbal. So, you know, it could be actually by text, it could be by phone, you know, something like that. But there's some kind of communication here. Okay, Spirit, give me more, please. What else does Pisces need to know? Okay, here. Okay, and who is Pisces? Okay. Okay, I'm loving this. So, Pisces, you are coming through as an owl. However, you are perched on a branch. You have both eyes open, though. That's a good sign. So you're seeing something clearly in this situation. And it's like your beak is actually like making a smile. So, but what I'm getting from this is, with whatever relationship this is for you, it may not be taking off just yet because the wings are not spread. It doesn't look like you're like getting ready for liftoff yet. But you look happy. You look really, really happy. You're definitely seeing something clearly here that makes you happy. Okay. Thank you, Spirit. That's really good news. Okay, here. Okay. Thank you. And who, is this Pisces? Oh, here. Okay, I see. Okay, who is this? Hold on a minute, Pisces. Wait a minute. Who is this? Okay. Okay, so this, oh, wow. Pisces, you are making some people very upset. Okay, so you're coming through in this vision as a masculine, okay? And it's like you're walking away. I'm literally seeing you walk away. And far behind you in the distance, there's one, two, three. Now, it doesn't mean it has to be three, okay? It can be any number as long as it's more than one. But it's basically a group of people, okay? Two or more. But I'm seeing three. And it's like somehow they're intertwined with each other and they're watching you. It's like you're so far, you've walked so far away, you're appearing very tiny. Okay, anything else from this, Spirit? Nope. Okay, so they are just very upset that you've walked away. Okay. All right. Spirit, go ahead and tell me, show me, or both within the cards. What would you like to tell Pisces, please? What does Pisces need to know? Pisces, I hope everyone is having a very beautiful week. Okay, thank you, Spirit. The dog. Spirit just reminded me of the dog. Okay, so the dog is actually, many of you have this as your spirit animal. That's going to be with you for some time. Tell me more about this dog, please, Spirit. Oh, okay. Okay. The dog is here mainly for protection. Okay. Interesting. Why, Spirit? Why is this dog here for protection mainly? Look at that. My ring just fell off. And as my ring was falling off, see, it fell off. As my ring was falling off, it was like I was seeing you, Pisces, with another person, and then that person with the big head coming in, causing some kind of issue. the ring fell off. So if this is a relationship, wow, if this is a relationship, Pisces, someone's going to try to interfere. So either someone who's toxic or someone, so this could be someone from the past, someone that, of course, that you knew. They're angry. You're making them angry because you walked away. Okay. Yeah. See, look, the tower. I can't make this up. Okay. But here's the thing with this tower card. Okay. That is rebuild, right? I just went through, well, two tower moments. I thought I was going to get one, two, but it's rebuild, right? It's rebuild. That's all I could say. And, you know, restructuring. So I am happy about the restructure. And I feel like with this King of Pentacles, that's exactly what you're going to be doing. Because as soon as this tower moment hits, I feel like that's just going to fuel you. This is going to bring you into an energy of not only is it authoritative, but it's and not just money. I feel like you're going to be very, like, in this energy of very nurturing, but very productive. And I feel like basically this tower from this person or group of people, it's going to like push you. It's kind of like going to make you feel like either, okay, I'm going to get angry or I'm going to use it to my advantage. That's what I'm getting here. And I feel like most of you are going to use it to your advantage. That's awesome. Okay, Spirit, give me more, please. Okay, thank you. What do we have? Two of Pentacles. Kind of going back and forth about something here. About an Empress. Can't make this up. Okay, so you may be... Okay, so I don't know if you can see. This is a new deck of cards. That one's a little dark. This is Empress. Okay, so it's Two of Pentacles with the Empress. So what I'm getting from this, in this situation, yeah, you're going back and forth here. Spirit, give me more about this Empress. Let's clarify. Is this Empress, is this the new person coming in or the new situation? Okay, thank you. What do we have? Two of Swords and the Fool. Okay. Interesting. So I feel like with this, there's something you feel, there's something that's making you feel trapped here. And I feel like with the Fool card, maybe it's something from your past. Maybe it's something, that you need to let go of. And not worry about making yourself feel trapped. I really feel like there's something here with this Empress. Interesting, Pisces. Spirit, give me more about this, about the Empress. What's going on with this Fool card? I realize it's a new journey, but I'm getting something different here. Oh, leave it. Okay. Thank you. What about this Fool card? What does that mean? Please clarify. Thank you. Okay. We have the Five of Swords. About some kind of conflict. This could be feeling foolish about this person with the big head when it comes to dealing with this new person coming in. That's what I'm getting. That's what I'm getting. It could be a situation, Pisces, that this person, some of you may fear that whatever this new relationship is, let's say this relationship is a job, and you take on this new relation or this new job, and you're in fear that an old boss is going to come in and try to cause you trouble. They might come in and say something that may only be like half the truth, twist it a little bit or something just to cause some trouble. But it might make you feel like you would look foolish. Something like that's what I'm getting here. Okay, we're going to go to a different deck. Thank you. What do we have? Yeah, Eight of Cups, change direction. I saw you walking away. I did see you walking away from that group of people that were angry. They were angry. What's this about, Spirit? Why are they angry? Are they angry just for the fact that Pisces is walking away or has walked away? What are they angry about? Yeah, this has been going on for a while for many of you. Thank you. These? Okay. Thank you. Okay, this one. Okay, thank you. And what do we have? Judgment. Yeah, we have the judgment, excuse me, with the Nine of Cups. Nine of Clouds. Nine of Cups. Because they're angry because they're going to be seeing you happy. If they're not angry right now, they're going to be in that energy. But they're going to be seeing you happy here. And when they do, that's when they really, or at least this one person with the big head, may try to cause some kind of huge stink here. Okay, whoa, Spirit just grabbed my, I'm not kidding you. Wow. Thank you, Spirit. Spirit just grabbed my hand, well, actually my pinky, and pulled it towards the crystal. Okay, hold on just a moment. Here? Oh my gosh. Pisces, there's a relationship coming. I'm telling you, there is a relationship. And I feel like for many of you, this is an actual like intimate relationship. Because Spirit's showing me again, two people kissing. One of the, and that's where Spirit was leading me to, pulling me. Wow. That's what this is about. That's why these people are going to be angry. So, yes. Okay, so Spirit, what is the outcome when this person or this group of people causes some kind of odd stuff to go on, hatefulness or whatever? What's the outcome for Pisces? Here, thank you. Okay, Spirit's just plainly showing me you walking away again. Okay. All right. Nothing else. Just that you're walking away again. Ah, thank you, Spirit. So Spirit just said quiet. So I feel like basically not, it's like pay attention to how you react to them in the situation. Is that everything? No. Okay. What else do we have, Spirit? Give me just a minute. Spirit's wanting to say something else. Okay, so I'm seeing, I've got to see what the meaning of a spruce tree is. I'm seeing a spruce tree. Oh, come off of there. Now I've gotten into some kind of something. Okay, Spirit, I can't get out of this. I don't know what I'm in on the phone. Okay, please explain to me about the spruce tree. What is it that you're trying to communicate? Okay, so I'm seeing like a field. Thank you, Spirit. So it's like being, it's flat. It's like being out in the edge of a forest with a huge open field. And I'm seeing all kinds of like lilies and little daisies. They're all, I mean, they're just bloomed. It's just beautiful. The grass, it's grown, but it's not like too high. It's kind of like mid-calf to, I would say, someone my height. I'm 5'8", so someone my height, mid-calf. So it's not that tall, but it's lush and it's a bright, vibrant green. And I'm seeing what's representing you, Pisces. And it's like you're just happy. You're spinning around. You're happy. And what about this spirit? What about the spruce tree? Eternal. Okay, eternal. What else? I feel round and round and round. Happiness. Cycles. Cycles of happiness. Eternal happiness. Soulmate. Soulmate. Okay. And what about the tree? More about the tree, please. Lots of growth. Because Spirit's just showing me again about, like, in the field, all of the flowers, all of the grass. Is there anything else, Spirit? Wow, this is like so, I don't know how to describe this, Pisces. Okay, so my stomach is feeling like, how can I even describe this, Spirit? Okay, my stomach is feeling like, in a very, very neat way. It doesn't hurt or anything, but it feels almost like my soul or my spirit wants to jump out of my stomach. I know this doesn't make sense. There's like some kind of excitement here, like true excitement, like something getting ready to take place, something getting ready to happen. Pure joy, pure happiness. What is it, Spirit? What is it? Can you tell me? What is this for Pisces? Nothing. I'm not getting anything. Anything at all, Spirit? Can you tell me at all? Okay, so I'm not allowed to know. It's like all of a sudden, Spirit just went, that's it. I can't tell you anymore. So I'm not allowed to know. I'm sorry, Pisces. I'm sorry. Okay, let's go ahead and go to some more cards and see what Spirit has for you. I'm going to go to the last deck of Oracle. Sometimes Pisces, when Spirit doesn't want me to know certain things, you know, it's kind of like sometimes when I ask about, you know, certain things in life, most of the time I get an answer, right? But then sometimes I get absolutely nothing because it's something that if spirit told me, like say it's something exciting, which whatever that feeling was in my stomach was something really, really exciting. So in situations like that, it's like sometimes, you know, it's like spirit won't let me know what's going to happen, because it would just like ruin my experience, right? Okay, so we have sometimes walking away. What? That's what it says. You see? Sometimes walking away is the only option. Not because you want to make someone else miss you or realize they took you for granted, but because you finally respect yourself enough to know you deserve better. Wow. Wow. Okay. And the last card, if you think you are alone, you are not. We are beside you in all challenges that you face. Trust that outside sources will always be working with you to ensure the best outcome in every situation. We have your best interests at heart. We love you. Oh, Pisces. I love that. I love it. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and close with that. My friends, may you have an extremely blessed and lovely week.